Hey guys, what's up? It's me, Abs, and today we are gonna be discussing AMD's APUs or accelerated processing units. Should you buy an APU instead of a normal CPU, or should you buy a decent graphics card with a CPU? To know for yourself, stay tuned. I am going to keep it as simple as possible. An APU is a processor which is embedded with a powerful R7 series graphics card in it. They are not the competitor of the highest end processors of Intel Core i5 or i7 series or even the FX8350. They are meant to work differently. They are mainly built to provide more FPS in games. Let's consider the A10 7850K, which is $160 and is a high-end APU of AMD. It has 4 CPU cores and 8 GPU cores. The CPU cores are built in the Steamroller architecture, and the GPU cores are built on the GCN architecture, which is also used in their graphics card like the R9290. So the APU will have support to DirectX 11.2, True Audio, and also Mantle. It is clocked to 3.7 GHz and has a max turbo boost to 4 GHz. Now, let's talk about its performance. The main performance boost comes from HSA, which allows the CPU and GPU to work together. As they are built on the same chip, so they don't need to really throw the information from CPU to GPU or from GPU to CPU. And also, as it supports Mantle, so throwing an AMD graphics card in the future will also improve performance in games and a decent performance for Mantle supported games. An APU like the 7850K without a graphics card will beat even the i7 series build without a graphics card in gaming by a long margin. Now, let's come to the benchmarks. In Battlefield 4, it gets an average FPS of 40 in low settings at 1080p. Getting 40 FPS on Battlefield 4 without a graphics card is more than impressive. Even the i7-4770K gets an average of 13 FPS on Battlefield 4 without a graphics card, which costs more than 2 times of a 7850K. So now you see why I said earlier that it will beat any processors out there in gaming by a long margin without a graphics card. Now, as many people nowadays still use the 720p monitors, so they will get more than 60 FPS easily at all times in Battlefield 4. So now, if you are really on a budget and you don't know much about graphics card or a gaming build, you can easily go with a APU like the 7850K and get a complete build in less than $300. You will be able to run all the latest games in low to mid settings without even a graphics card. And in the future, you may put in another low-end AMD card in it for more performance and maybe use Mantle for Mantle supported games. Now, let's come to the limitations of the APUs. When you shouldn't buy it. Well, if you are in a bigger budget and you can afford a complete build with a graphics card more than the R9270, then you shouldn't go with an APU, because the cards higher than the R9270 or the R9270 itself is powerful enough to handle GPU intensive tasks, and you need a good CPU to go alongside with the high-end cards to maximize performance. As APUs have more GPU cores, making them better on graphical stuff, but they are not as good in CPU intensive tasks. So if you can afford a complete build with the graphics card more than the R9270, then you should go with the CPUs like the AMD FX series or the Intel i5 or i7 series for maximizing performance. Going with a higher end card with these processors will beat the APUs using the same high end cards. So, I hope I have cleared your concept about APUs and when you should buy them and when you shouldn't. Don't forget to smash that like button and subscribe for more tech videos. If you have a question, leave a comment below. Also, like my official Facebook page and join my Facebook group, or you can follow me on Twitter and ask any question you want. The links are in the description below, and hopefully I'll see you in my next video. Bye for now.